Ladies and gentlemen, good evening, and welcome to the Spotlight Review 2007.
Yeah. announcement to make, ladies and gentlemen. A few final do's and don'ts as we head into the performance. Please, 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 turn off all mobile phones, or at least put them on vibrate.
She knows what you're talking about.
And please, don't cough!
Air temps go reactors off.
All right, there's an hour of stuff for me.
But please, don't cough!
Don't say what? To every line you think you have got. And if you're in a snit because you missed the plot of, which I must admit is not an awful lot, still don't.
Got to wait.
If something's true, please don't call a phone.
Let go of it! Come on, get old, Jay! Don't keep me waiting!
Dressing green is there to muck about and degrade. You bloody age, you won't degrade me! I'm going home. I'll get away from you, you apes! Oh, back. I don't give a tuppence what you say. You don't mean anything to me, your bloody orders, nor your stripes, nor your jankers, nor your wars. Stick your jankers on the walls! Stuff yourselves, go on and stuff yourselves! Stop your rotten, stupid selves! There's more important things in life than just the army. I mean, look at the sky. Look at the moon. Jesus, look at that moon, the frost in the air. Oh, wait. It's quiet now, the noise is gone. I'll sit and wait and look at that moon. It's bloody cold. Can't stay out freezing there. Hey, now that's a laugh, now that fool them. Hey, listen, a bike, a motorbike, a roaring bloody motorbike! London, 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 London! Stupid git! Can't you see I want to live? A soldier wants to live back home! Home, you bastards, take me home! Bastards! Now they'll catch me, now they'll come. There's not much point going on. They're bound to miss you back in camp, eyes like hawks they've got. Come on, who cares?
Stop your silly smiling, soldier!
It's not a smile, Sarge. Honest, Sarge. It's natural. I was born this way. Honest, Sarge. It's not a smile.
I don't know.
I've got it. We're going to make a lady out of you.
A lady, Mr. Biggins?
Yes. Now repeat after me. The rain in Spain stays mainly on the plain.
The rain in Spain stays mainly on the plain.
That will never do. Again, the rain in Spain stays mainly on the plain.
The rain in Spain stays mainly on the plain.
I think she's got it. By Jove, she's got it. And once again, where does it rain?
On the plain, on the plain.
And where's that blasted plain?
A night will change when tomorrow comes.
attention. In overcrowded hallways, the thank you.
we met last year at Spotlight Review 2006.
That was his dad's idea.
My dad thought that a son educated in Blackpool would be a gold star on his resume, as well as mine.
Isn't that just pathetic?
I've had a break.
Not him, you. Want to have a gold star on your resume?
Me? I was gay.
He's gay.
Well, I'm gay.
He's gay.
I came out from the word go.
What?
Well, the moment the plane touched English soil, I was out. But I wasn't just out, I was screaming.
Ow!
I was advertising.
Yoo-hoo!
I was carrying billboards.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'd walk up to complete strangers. You're right. Do you know me?
No.
Know who I am?
No.
Know what I'm about?
No.
Well, I'm gay.
They get everywhere these days.
And then there was Max.
And there was me.
You just kept popping up.
I just kept popping up, really.
Yeah. In the studio.
Hey, Max, you know what? You've got to be fit to be gay,
yeah. Oh, yeah.
Because all you've got are these gay pride dances and marches. That's just walking, you know.
In
the march the bar, perhaps. Can I still get a nice big diesel dice for the marching for you? She can buy you a drink, take you home, fill it with your bits, and you can still be proud! Go on.
In the refectory.
Hey, Matt. What do men do that women don't do?
I don't know what do men do that women don't do.
Well, they piss standing upright. Right. That's it. That's all they do. Worked it out.
Then at a party. Hey Max,
what?
How would you tell a gay man?
I don't know, how would you tell a gay man?
Right, well no matter how big, how butch, or how brawny, as soon as he sees another gay man he goes, YOOHOO!
And that brings us to tonight, really. Yeah. Well, if you want a lift after the show.
I can't.
Why not?
Going out with David.
David?
Yeah.
No you're not.
Yeah I am.
No you're not.
Yeah I am.
Not till he's finished, you know.
What do you mean?
Don't want to know. Phil.
Yeah, thanks, David. Let's go. Bloody David.
Wasn't so. Your type anyway.
Let me be used. Think about it, though. Blackpool is famous for its fresh air and fun.
Hey, Chris.
Yeah?
Tell them about last year at Blackpool Zoo.
Eh?
You know, the lion, Albert.
Oh, the one that was in the paper.
That's the one?
Yeah, all right. Here, listen to this. Albert Ramsbottom's family came here.
With your Albert?
Their son.
Yeah, a grand little lad was young Albert, all dressed in his best, quite a swell, with a stick with an horse's head and up. The finest that Woolworths could sell.
Well, them Ramsbottoms didn't think much of the ocean. They said our waves were fiddling and small. There were no wrecks, and nobody drowned it. In fact, nothing to laugh at all. So seeking for further amusement, they paid them an entrance to when the lions, tigers, camels, and all daily sandwiches too.
Yeah, and there were that one great big lion called...
What was it called?
Wallace!
Wallace.
His nose were all covered with scars.
Yeah, and he lay in a somnolent posture with the side of his face at the bar.
Yes.
Now Albert heard about lions, how they were ferocious and wild. To see Wallace lying so peaceful, it didn't seem right to a child. So, straight away, the brave little fella, showing a morsel of fear, he took his stick with his horse's head and nose. He shoved it in Wallace's ear.
Yeah, and you could tell the lion didn't like it for giving a kind of a roll. Pulled out inside the cage with him and swallowed the little lad down. But then Pa, who saw the occurrence and didn't know what to do next, said,
Mother! Your lion's at Albert.
And Mother said,
well, I am vexed.
Then Mr. and Mrs. Ramsbottom, quite rightly so when all said and done, complained to the animal keeper that the lion had eaten their son.
The keeper was quite nice about it. He said,
what a nasty mishap. But you sure that it's your boy he's eating?
And Pa said,
am I sure? There's his cap.
Well, the manager, he had to be sent for. He came and he said,
what did you do?
Then Mother said,
right, young fella. I think it's a shame and a sin for a lion to go and eat Albert, and after we'd pay to come in.
Well, the manager wanted no trouble, so he took out his purse right away and he said,
Albert's to her! Settle the matter!
Well, how much do you usually pay?
But at that, Mother turned a bit awkward, and she thought whether Albert had gone, she said,
no! Someone's got to be summoned!
So that was decided upon.
So, off they went to the police station in front of the magistrate's chap, and they told him what happened to Albert and proved it by showing his cap.
The magistrate gave his opinion that no one was really to blame, and he said he hoped the Ramsbottoms would have further sons to their name.
At that, Mother got proper blazing.
And thank you, sir, kindly,
said she.
What? Waste all our lives raising children to feed ruddy lions? Not me.
What do you do with a BA in English? What is my life going to be? 4 years of college and plenty of knowledge have earned me this useless degree. I can't pay the bills yet, 'cause I have no skills yet. The world is a big scary place, but somehow I can shake the feeling I might make a difference to the human race.
Hey, Brian!
Hi, Kate!
How's life?
Disappointing.
Aw, what's the matter?
The catering company laid me off.
Aw, I'm sorry.
Me too, I mean, look at me, I'm 4 years out of college, I always thought, oh.
What?
No, it sounds stupid.
Aw, come on!
When I was little, I thought I would be a big comedian on late night TV. But now I'm 22, and as you can see, I'm not.
Nope.
Oh well.
Uh-huh.
It sucks to be me.
No.
It
retard!
Hey, Robin, can you got a second? Can you sell something for us?
Certainly.
Who likes that spawn? Ryan or mine?
Ours. We live together.
Most as people can get.
We've been the best of buddies.
Ever since the day we met.
So he knows lots of ways to make me really upset. Oh, every day is an aggravation.
Oh, that's exaggeration.
You leave your clothes out. You put your feet on my chair.
And yeah, you do such anal things like ironing your underwear.
You make that very small apartment we share.
Why are you looking all the way up here?
I started out on the way
camels of the desert?
A camel?
Yeah, a camel.
A camel, Aggie.
Well, the open front legs of the camel.
You call that a leading part?
Well, it was a leading part of a camel.
Oh, Aggie, you are a one. We've got two of the dressing rooms to clean yet.
Come on, get that light out. I don't know. Some
speeches I don't want to know. Go!
I have to see my God. started. What you started. I didn't start this. God's thy will is hard. But you hold every part. I will drink your cup of poison. Nail me to your cross and leave me. Bleed me, beat me, kill me.
Ireland is a green and pleasant land with a history that stretches far beyond the dawn of Christianity. It is a land of verdant fields and wild moors, of misty hills and golden beaches. A country where the rhythm of life is dictated by nature and follows still the ancient ways of its forefathers. It is a place where legend, myth and enchantment serve to underline its tempestuous history. Where Celtic traditions and culture, honed by adversity and sharpened by hardship, still flourish, and are the essential source of inspiration to its many poets, storytellers, musicians and dancers, who demonstrate a remarkable capability to bring the past into the present, and which is so ably demonstrated by the wonderful music and dance presented here. creatures call in certain nuts to terrorize your neighborhood. And whosoever shall be found without the soul for paying down must stand and face the hounds of hell and rot inside a corpse's shell. The foulest stenches in the air, a sepulchre of 40,000 years, and grisly ghouls from every tomb are closing to seal your doom. No one fight to stay alive. Your body starts to shiver, for no mere mortal can resist the evil of the thriller.
Fagin! Fagin!
Oh!
I've brought Ifrin to see you. Oliver Twist.
Oh. I shall have the honour of making your intimate acquaintance, Oliver. Very glad to meet you. Very. Dodger tells me you've come to London to see your fortune. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Well, we're left empty with that. What are we not, Oliver? Aye! Give it his bag back! Give it back! Here, Oliver. Are you hungry?
Yes, sir.
Would you like a sausage?
Yes, sir.
Rats! Take the sausage off the fire, don't you? Find Oliver a seat. Oi! Put her back on your feet!
Yeah! Leave her alone!
Shut up, legs! I'll see you admiring our pocket handkerchiefs, Oliver. Very nice, aren't they?
Yes, sir. Is this a laundry?
He's a little better. Don't it, boys?
Yeah!
Come on, let's show him. In this life, one thing counts. In the bank, large amounts. I'm afraid these don't grow on trees. You gotta pick a pocket or slip. You gotta pick a pocket or two. Boys, you gotta pick a pocket or two.
Large amounts don't grow on trees. You gotta pick a pocket or two.
Let's show them rest and show them onions. Oh, why should we break our backs stupidly paying sex? Better get some unsexed income. Better pick a pocket or two. You gotta pick a pocket or two. Boys, you gotta pick a pocket or two. Robin Hood, what a crook, gave away what he took. Charity spies, subscribe to mine. Get out, pick a pocket or two. You gotta pick a pocket or two. Boys, you gotta pick a pocket or two.
Robin Hood's far too good. He had to pick a pocket or two.
Take a tip from Bill Sykes, he can whip what he likes. I recall he started small, he had to pick a pocket or two. You gotta pick a pocket or two, boys. You gotta pick a pocket or two.
We three like old Bill Sykes, he had to pick a pocket or two.
Dear old Jim, passing by, something nice takes his eye. Everything's clear and saccharine. Get in a bigger pocket or two. You got a bigger pocket or two. Boys, you got a bigger pocket or two. Someone rich, both my bones start to wink. Only to find some peace of mind, have to pick a pocket or two. You gotta pick a pocket or two, boys. You gotta pick a pocket or two. Well done.
for me?
Maybe.
Let's have a look.
Nice wallet.
Very nice. Not as bad as it could be, but very nicely made.
Nice handkerchief.
Very nice.
Times two.
Oi!
No, times three.
Hey!
Did you make them, sir?
With his lily wallet!
What have you got in?
Just an handkerchief.
Bring it here. Nonsense! The lady's here!
Lady! Cool rocket, put me a lady! Charmed, I'm sure. Hey, Fagan, got any gin?
Any gin? Gin's a very dangerous thing for a girl like you, Nancy.
Why, that's one of my few pleasures in life, Fagan. Who would not have that small pleasure?
Ladies like this.
Of course
I do. I'll show you.
Jump, Dodge!
there are. If everything for your smile, everything for your smile, everything I see.
Would you climb a hill?
Anything.
Wear a daffodil?
Anything.
Thank you. worn a little thin. I was wondering if you had an opening, and if you did, could you squeeze me in?
You do?
My girl.
Oh, what a sweet little gesture of affection.
Do it.
But pray, Mr. Penquistle, why did
like you have to do with the ball in your hand.
She knew I had it.
Another thing, Gallagher. You missed two passes in a row. You missed Snorkels and Lindquist. So you finally caught one from Liebschmann.
I caught that one.
But why did you catch only Liebschmann's?
Because I'm mad at the others.
Why? Lindquist, why did you stop and tie your shoelace?
Because my mother said neatness is the most important thing.
Good mom.
I love my mom.
Good mom.
And now we come to you, Snorkel. You were positively brilliant. Never have I seen more clever passing and superb fielding. You were the most outstanding player on that field.
Nice coach.
Let me shake your hand, son. It's a pity you're running the wrong way!
My glasses
are all right, all right! We've got them 68 to nothing! Now let's get out there and see who do better!
Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah! Come on, Lola. Let's go.
When you pay up,
gets the money?
Every dollar.
All I'm trying to find out is the guy's name on first base.
Who?
The guy that gets... Who gets the money?
He does every dollar. Sometimes his wife comes down and lets it. Sometimes Amy lets
Who's wife?
Yes.
All I want to know is when you sign up the first baseman every month, how does he sign his name?
W-H-O who?
The guy.
Who?
How does he sign?
That's how he signs it.
Who?
Yes.
Look, all I want to know is what's the guy's name on first base?
No. What is on second base?
I don't ask you who's on second
base. Who's on first?
What base is it?
I'm going to change the players around.
I'm not changing nobody. I'll break your arm. I'm only asking you who's on first.
That's right.
Okay. What's the guy's name on first?
What is on second?
I'm going to ask you who's on second.
Who's on first?
I don't know.
He's on third. What have I been talking about here? Well, why did you mention his name?
If I mention the third baseman's name, then who does he play third?
Who's playing first?
What's on first?
What's on second?
I don't know.
He's on third.
Go back on third again.
That's it. I'm enough of your stupid games. I'm off.
Wait. Please, wait.
That's right.
Who? Ladies and gentlemen, it's showtime.
Peter,
This bloody meeting in London, I've only just got back.
She's going to be all right. All first-time fathers get worried.
I suppose you're right. Do you know why I'm worried?
Why,
Dave? I've had this awful premonition all day that something awful's going to happen, and I can't get this feeling out of my mind.
Well, why don't you have a large scotch and I'll join you, eh?
Marsh. Jones, Mr. Marsh and I will have a large scotch.
On the rocks, please, Jones. Thank you very much. You know what, James? Me and you, we go a long way back.
Of course.
We've been through thick and thin, and we've grown very close. Okay? I want you to take my words very carefully. Oh. Thank you, Jones. Look, I've had an idea. They're having a party next door, and they've hired a fortune teller. Now, I'll go over there and ask her to come here to see you. She'll give you a few soothing words and get rid of all your silly premonitions.
A fortune teller? Yes. Do you think it might work?
It's worth a try. I'll be back in a sec. Wait there.
Yes, hello, is that Moorgate Hospital? Yes, I'm asking after Mrs. Gregory in the maternity ward. Not yet. You'll let me know as soon as anything happens. Thank you.
Oh, James! This is Madame Zola, Madam Zola. This is James Gregory.
Ah, yes. Can we sit down?
Of course.
You see?
Now, Mr. Gregory. I understand your wife is having a baby. Now let me see. Oh, God!
What is it?
This is going to be difficult, Mr. Gregory. Can you be brave?
Of course I can. What is it?
Can you be brave?
Yes, I can. Tell me, woman.
Your wife. Baby, I have something to tell
then
you.
Then tell me!
When the baby's born, if it's a girl, the mother will die. And if it's a boy, the father will die.
If it's a girl, the mother will die. And if it's a boy, the father will die.
No, James. Yes, this is the Gregory residence. James, your wife has given birth to a bouncing baby boy.